Hello and welcome to Blink Strategic Solutions, your consultative learning partner for over 10 years in the field of behavioral leadership and digital marketing programs. Hi, this is Pradnya here, a digital strategist, executor, Google certified trainer for digital unlock programs designed for entrepreneurs, businesses, and individuals, as well as a corporate digital facilitator and consultant. This year, 2020, has started with COVID outburst and challenges thereafter, both on our personal and professional life. Businesses' plans were tweaked, changed to meet the current situations. Businesses changed their approach, which led to more online presence in terms of customer engagement, interactions, live sessions, webinars, online learning, and more. Many companies took a conscious call to upgrade the skills of their employees to ensure they are equipped and able to survive in the new normal, as we call it today. Blink Strategic Solution has been no exception. We quickly moved on to virtual training module through varied platforms. Our facilitators empowered themselves to virtual programs, while we ensured the programs delivered equivalent engagement, interaction, and ultimately impactful takeaways for our participants. During last 3 months, we designed and delivered virtual training programs on topics like high impact presentation skills, assertive communication, measuring training effectiveness through online platforms, virtual business communication etiquettes, social selling skills, digital transformation programs for sales and marketing, LinkedIn for businesses, social media for CXOs, CEOs and leaders, and many more. Clearly, digital is a winner today, and it is a need of an hour for businesses to rethink their digital strategy. Companies are also considering equipping their sales and marketing services, HR teams to harness the power of digital and that the businesses can do with it. With this, I am happy to have Suhasini Kirloskar, the founder of MarketAxess. Suhasini is always up to something interesting, and the latest from her is she's created an online learning course for B2B content strategy. At MarketAxess, she has successfully built a global customer base for marketing strategy and services. Suhasini is here with us today to share her insights on how companies can harness the power of social media to build brand ambassadors. With this, over to you, Suhasini, and welcome here.
Hey, Pradnya. Thanks so much for this opportunity and for inviting me. Is my audio clear?
Yes, it's clear.
And you can see my slide as well.
Yes, yes.
Great. So I will start. We are talking about how to create social media brand ambassadors throughout the company, throughout the organization. Okay. So we'll start today's session by asking the question, does social media even matter? And there's a reason for asking this question, because although it is 2020, there is still a digital divide. And I don't mean that people don't have access to digital platforms, because most of the people that, you know, you are targeting and our viewers are targeting probably do have access to digital platforms. But I mean that there are some people who either have a low awareness or they choose to ignore digital trends. So I'll tell you a funny story way back in history. You know, initially when I first graduated from college, we used to do business even without like emails. Okay, yeah, I'm from that far back. But after we had been using emails for like 10 years, I was making a presentation to a company, and I suggested, you know, email marketing. And the prospective client, the manager at the prospective client, came up with an objection saying email is not relevant because my wife still doesn't use email. And that threw me off completely. You know, I was sort of not prepared for that objection. Today, you still have people who say that, you know, if I'm not on Twitter, then Twitter doesn't matter. Or if I'm not on Instagram, Instagram doesn't matter. But because I'm much wiser from that day, I have brought data, okay? So I'll show you data that proves that social media does matter. Okay, so this slide that you see is, can you see the slide?
Yes, we can.
Yeah, okay. So this slide that you see is January 2020 data, which is about the global penetration of social media. And I would like our viewers to take like half a minute and read the slide. It's the second and third numbers that you should be looking at. So out of a total world population of 7.75 billion people, 3.8 billion people, or about 49%, are on social media. Now, this is considering the total population of the world, which includes like children and, you know, people who live in forests and whatever. So you can be sure that in the market segment that you operate, the penetration is much higher. And the third number is also very interesting because this use of social media is growing at over 9% per year. So we all know that, you know, our brands are very important. And now we've understood that social media is very important. And, you know, that's the reason why branding on social media is really very strategic for your business. So now my question is, who is the custodian of your brand on social media? Just think about that question. And the reason I bring up this question is that social media marketing is often considered to be the responsibility of, like, you know, a central or a corporate function, you know, that the marketing team does on social media, and that's it. But I'll illustrate a different approach with the help of these slides. So on this slide, you see the LinkedIn account of Slack, which is the fastest growing business app in the world. And this is their corporate social media handle. And a corporate social media handle will always have this kind of typical look, feel, flavor, okay? So it will have the right, you know, branding guidelines. It will have the right elements. It will be aligned with all their, you know, corporate colors. And it will be totally correct, okay? So I'm not saying that it's bad to be correct, but I'm just saying, is the corporate social media handle the best face for your brand on social media? And to understand my question, I'm going to show you another face of Slack. So this is taken from the LinkedIn of the founder, Stuart Butterfield. Now, the post that you see here is probably not very correct. It takes a snide swipe at Microsoft Teams. So what has happened is that in the post, you see that there's a news report that Microsoft Teams has sort of gone down just when the entire world is moving to work from home. So a Slack user has shared that news item and said that he's glad his company chose Slack. Now, Stuart Butterfield, because Slack was tagged in that, you know, Stuart Butterfield has shared that post once again and shared the appreciation and repeated the line in that person who had posted his post that you get what you pay for, which is like a very snide swipe at Microsoft Teams. Now, the post has generated, when I took the screenshot, it had generated about 106 engagements, meaning likes and so on. But this one post conveys a lot, actually. It conveys that Slack is a game changer, a challenger to a much older and, you know, better established competitor. And it also conveys that Slack is better equipped to handle the whole new work from home culture, which, as you said, you know, all that has come in from in 2020. So this one post has said all that, you know. So when a person communicates something, it tends to have much more flavor. Of course, there is nothing more powerful in the world than the connection between one person to another. So when we read a Facebook post or a tweet, we instinctively know when an individual is sort of communicating from the heart, and that elicits a very different response from us than if it's just like from a marketing machinery. Okay, so how are brands leveraging this, you know, kind of personal and from the heart communication? So data is available for the world's largest companies, which is what you see on the slide. 54% of Fortune 500 CEOs have some sort of social presence, some social presence, okay? So what do 46% have? I would say a missed opportunity. And this is just the data for the world's largest companies, 500 top companies. But in the larger companies, if you look at another role, say head of engineering or head of product development, what would be the percentage? Maybe lower? What about CFOs, chief financial officers? Definitely lower. What about smaller companies? Are they doing any better? What about chief marketing officers? Better, hopefully. So this data may be different in your industry, but across the board, there is still a huge potential to increase your brand presence and amplify your brand messages by drawing on the power of individuals communicating on social media. So let's create more brand ambassadors, starting from the CEO, yes, hopefully, but also other business leaders, managers, and finally, possibly all colleagues. Okay, so that's what we're here today in this webinar to discuss. So here's research that shows the tangible benefits of social CEOs like Stuart Butterfield and a few others that we're going to see today. And I'm going to give viewers a minute just to read this slide. Companies get higher employee engagement, better sales, and the ability to attract talent when the CEO is social. But there are a lot of benefits for a lot of other managers to be social as well. So what can brand ambassadors do? Okay. The first thing is they create an interesting buzz around the company, around the brand. Here we see Satya Nadella. He's talking about a huge investment into Italy. And it's always interesting for us to hear from people about, you know, new technologies which are being researched, new products in development. And there's a slight difference in flavor. So when it's announced by the company's like official social channel, it has to be very specific. Possibly it can be shared only after the, you know, thing has been completed. But an individual can give us a sense of getting a sneak peek behind the scenes, which kind of makes it more interesting. Those of you who are working in listed companies, I must kind of beware you that you have to comply with, you know, stock exchange disclosure regulations. So please check on that before you, you know, plan anything along these lines, what we discussed, like products which are under development and so on. But others, yeah, do think about this. So brand ambassadors also become proof of the values and personality of the brand. On this slide, okay, this is from a tweet by Anand Mahindra. And as you see, he has tweeted 20,000 times. Okay? He has, I can't see the number of followers over here, but okay, so this tweet, the one you see on the lower part of the slide is a tweet by Mr. Mahindra. And the person that he has tagged, the Twitter handle, Rajesh at Rajesh664, that is actually Mr. Rajesh Jejurikar, who is Mr. Mahindra's own colleague. So this message, Mr. Mahindra could have tweeted by an email or a WhatsApp message. So what is happening here? Here we are seeing the relief efforts which are being done for the migrant labor. You know, the whole crisis that we are facing right now during the lockdowns for the COVID-19 situation. So what this brand Swaraj Tractors has done, and then Mr. Mahindra has called out his colleague, Mr. Rajesh Jejurikar, you know, appreciating the effort and what more needs to be done. So brand ambassadors, as we said, they become proof of the values and the, you know, personality of the brand. Now, this tweet from Mr. Mahindra, it gives us a feel of the efforts that the group is taking to solve the problem of the migrant labor during the COVID-19 crisis. It sort of tells us that this is a work in progress. And it's very different from the way an official channel would have announced it, you know, that we have helped transport so many people, like after it's over. So if you say that your brand is all about caring, then the brand ambassador makes it more real. And one more thing that brand ambassadors can do, they demonstrate thought leadership. So many brands, they aspire to be seen as thought leaders in their field. Now, while it's nice to have, you know, professionally produced white papers, research reports, but there's a special value in a social media post that demonstrates ideas or, you know, goals that the leader is pursuing passionately. So in my mind, this one tweet by Elon Musk about what needs to happen before we can have cities on Mars. Now, this demonstrates thought leadership better than, you know, most professional looking publications that I've seen. So when we look at these examples, Anand Mahindra, Elon Musk, remember that these are extremely, extremely busy people, probably among the busiest people in the world, and also some of the most successful people. I'll just go up again. Elon Musk. Elon Musk not only has, you know, multiple companies like Tesla, SpaceX, and so on, but he also has a little baby, only a few weeks old, and still he is tweeting. So why are such busy people tweeting, you know, Mr. Mahindra or Mr. Elon Musk? It's because they know the value of tweeting. Okay? So one more thing that brand ambassadors can do and can achieve with social media is that they can manage crisis. So Richard Branson, you know, normally he's a flamboyant social media user. It's really interesting as well as entertaining to see his posts and tweets. He shares interesting aspects about his regular work, his teams, plus his work for the oceans and environment, his adventure sports. There's always something exciting going on. But with the COVID-19 crisis, and the huge impact on the airline industry specifically, there were a lot of negative rumors about the Virgin Group, okay? And here he has shared an open, kind of open letter to settle those rumors. Now, I've deliberately taken a screenshot from his Facebook account because there are some people who say that Facebook is not for business, not appropriate for business. But if your target audience is there, then you need to be there too. So on crisis management, just a thought, I don't understand why Bill Gates is sort of not using social media currently when there are all these conspiracy theories that, you know, he has actually created the coronavirus or he is actually trying to sort of control humanity or wipe out humanity or something. I think that some crisis management from his side is in order. But anyway, moving on. Okay. So we saw that some of the most successful and busy people in the world make the time and effort to post on social media and not just once in a while. In fact, they are prolific. So although we saw some celebrity examples today, there are many other regular working people who are helping to build the brands that they represent by leveraging the different channels like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, and more. So if your colleagues are not doing this, then what's holding them back? The main reason, I believe, is that they don't know what they can achieve. We saw that business leaders who are active on social media, they help to increase sales, increase employee engagement, and attract talent. So who would not want this? That's why I really believe it's a lack of awareness of the power of social media. And that's why, you know, some people are not active. So they don't make time for it. And they say that they don't have time for it. Today, you've seen the power of social media and brand ambassadors. So feel free to use my slides if you need to convince, you know, your colleagues. And just a few of your colleagues, if they become active on social media, you will see a huge impact and you will find huge returns, which will be in the form of brand awareness, enhancing the perception of your brand, building new contacts, and even closing deals. So there's also one more hindrance that is preventing people from embracing this, and that is sort of, there's a certain diffidence, like I don't know exactly how to kind of go about this, okay? So in order to make the magic of social media brand ambassadors happen, we have to help our colleagues to overcome those challenges that are holding them back. And we need to design a program. It's not going to happen just by chance. So let's look at what this social media brand ambassadors program would entail. So the first thing that we need to do is recruit our brand ambassadors. And for this, start speaking to a few colleagues. Encourage those who are natural communicators. Don't try to force people who are, you know, uncomfortable with the whole idea. It would be very nice for you to have the CEO to coach and, you know, create a brand ambassador, mold him in, him or her into becoming a brand ambassador. But do see the potential, recognize the potential in other colleagues as well. Someone in field sales also could share interesting anecdotes, experiences, even photographs of you know, users or field salespeople traveling and the length and breadth of the country or in interesting places with interesting people, customers, users. A colleague from customer support could use social media to directly address common questions or concerns. So start your program with just a small number of colleagues and then let the number grow in a kind of a natural way. Next, we come to the crux of your brand ambassador program, which is communicate the brand's vision, mission, and values to all potential ambassadors. Plan some time, talk to them in depth, share with them the brand voice, and show them how they can use this when they also embrace social media. It's only when all representatives of your brand are aligned and speaking in a similar voice will there be really that positive impact that you are seeking. So for example, if you say that your brand voice is to be very, you know, helpful and a courteous advisor, is to be a helpful and courteous advisor to your customers, then this has to be translated to how they respond to queries on social media or complaints, you know, with patience and courtesy. So you also need to protect the brand from any risk of unpleasantness. So does your organization have like a social media usage guidelines in place? Or this may be a good time for you to look at this and kind of roll this out as well. And communicate that you have zero tolerance for any kind of online abuse. Amplify corporate messaging. So what does this mean? So I always feel a little sad when I see corporate marketing teams like put in a lot of effort to create social media content, but other team members sort of just ignore it. Okay, they don't engage at all. Some of them, you don't even follow social, the official social media channels, the corporate social channels. And others do follow, but they hardly ever like share the content from there. The network of our colleagues on different social channels can be very relevant for our branding messages. For example, a business development manager is likely to have, you know, LinkedIn connections who are current prospects, customers, past customers. All these people, they may or may not follow the corporate social media handle or the LinkedIn page. So if the corporate social media handle publishes a lovely post, say a recent achievement of the company, a success story, it'll get very relevant viewership if the business development manager also shares it. So when you create your brand ambassador program, try to sensitize more colleagues about the importance of sharing this content, which is published by the corporate social media managers, and ask the social media managers also to follow the brand ambassadors and other colleagues. In this way, the messages, they amplify further. Finally, I'll say, Pradnya, that we also need to help colleagues with practical aspects, how to use hashtags, how to tag colleagues, how to connect with influencers, engage influencers, how to use images or video effectively. And when we are rolling out a social media brand ambassadors program, take ideas, allow ideas to flow creatively and encourage contributions to get the maximum impact. Okay, so that's a very short capsule of the plan. Why don't you ask me if you have you know, any questions? I'd love to take that.
Thank you, Suhasini. That has been really insightful. Yeah, it's a small capsule, but yeah, we really need to take it up well and consistently. So one question, Suhasini, probably I would like to ask, and it is there in most of the people's mind, is which platform should one choose and why? Because that's where, you know, we need to begin with.
Right, very, very good question, Pradnya. So there are a number of social media platforms which are very relevant for business. Okay, so today's landscape, we look at LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok also. A lot of brands are being, you know, are marketing very effectively on TikTok. Each one has their own flavor. Each platform has like its own flavor, own strengths and audience profile also. Research today shows that, for example, Facebook is popular with a slightly older audience now, but also richer. Okay. A very good platform for young people today is Instagram, and a lot of brands have been built on that. Now, for B2B marketing, we definitely recommend LinkedIn. And there's a lot that you can do on LinkedIn. So it's not just about like kind of being there, but you can effectively use the LinkedIn post, your own personal posts, which is where you share content. And that content communicates a lot about your business and what value you can deliver to the audience. It's very good for networking. It's very good for, you know, building your network of contacts who will actually be ready to have a one-to-one conversation with you, which is the most valuable finally. And LinkedIn works very effectively with search. You can actually search for people who are looking for a company like yours or a service like yours. A lot of people don't use LinkedIn search very effectively. So LinkedIn is really important for B2B marketing. Facebook is also good, not only for B2C, but also some B2B brands like learning and development, they do well on Facebook. Personal development, a lot of education brands, they do well on Facebook. For B2C, Facebook is extremely powerful. There are brands that have got built completely on Facebook. Today, there are some clothing brands and fashion brands, which I'm sure you also may have shopped from. I think a brand called Jaipur, if I'm not mistaken. I've really never seen a store of that brand. I don't think there is a store of that brand. But it has built its brand awareness, and actually, we all buy their garments and products. So Facebook is important. It is the world's largest social media platform. And as I said, the richest people are on Facebook. Okay. Again, these are good platforms for building. If you want to like get into a new market, even an overseas market, all these are extremely valuable. Now, Instagram is really very, very valuable for someone whose business is extremely visual. You know, so for architects, designers, of course, fashion, lifestyle, art, resorts, hospitality, hotels, these are very, 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 Instagram should be your primary like choice. And many brands are using it very effectively. I really like Instagram a lot because there's less of, you know, general noise over there, less abuse and arguments. It's just visual with a little bit of text. And it's very, very helpful to engage with influencers. For example, in the automotive industry, the influencers, they have a huge impact, you know, as well as in some other industry. So for that, you should be looking at Instagram. And TikTok has also an interesting ability to reach certain audiences. It is, of course, purely on video, and that too short video, extremely short video. So if you can deliver your brand message in that short, crisp, engaging manner on video with a little bit of creativity, it will reach certain audiences that otherwise are not there on any media and platform. So I hope that answers your question.
Yes, I think it answers more than what we have expected. And a very clear guideline is something that is like a takeaway through this question, that, you know, the way you've answered that which platform and how one can really leverage it for the business. So Suhasini, it's been real great to have you here today. And we are hoping to have more such sessions and interactions going forward. With this, also, I would like to say that we are open to take up consulting projects. We are working with a lot of companies on developing their brand ambassadors. We are taking digital marketing programs, the transformation programs that we call them. So Suhasini and the team is here. We all are here. And we would definitely like to hear it from you all. Here are coordinates. You can email us on events at theblinkstrategicsolutions.com. and there is our number. So we are probably just a call away or an email away, and we are quite active on social media, so do reach us out there as well. Also, Suhasini, thanks a lot once again for being there. And
thank you, Pradnya. So because of COVID-19, I'm not demanding anything, but you owe me a coffee and some brownies. So
yes,
after COVID-19.
Yes. All right, Suhasini, we'll meet up soon.
It's raining in Pune today. So yeah, it was just the weather for coffee and brownies. If only we were together.
soon. I think this time shall to pass.
Yes, it will. It will. Here's to coffee and brownies next time.
All right, Suhasini. See you. Have
Thanks,
a great day.
Thank you. Bye. Thank you. Bye.